Okay.
Hi.
Hi, how you doing?
I thought we were on the same time zone, because I'm in Texas, so I'm on Central Time. I'm sorry, I forgot. I messed up on that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think you are 1 hour behind.
I'm behind.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. So, Antoinette, yes, ma'am. How did you find out about me?
On YouTube.
So how do you come across my videos on YouTube?
You know what? I was looking up shows. I was looking up online about Deliverance Ministry, and your thing came up. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. So I was looking for Deliverance Ministry because, like I told you, like I said, I didn't give you a lot of details, but yes, ma'am, I've been going through a situation here. You know, stuff is moving all over in my body and on my skin and everything. And so it's been a journey. This has been going on for like a year now.
Now, where your family lineage from? I'm picking up a little accent.
I'm Jamaican. Yes, ma'am.
Figured with Jamaican. Now, that movement in your body, you know, this python, that snake.
I can tell it's something. I can feel it. It moves.
Yeah, because before the Lord delivered me, that spirit was in me, and it moved. Just like a baby. Like a baby. My belly, my oldest daughter, I'm pregnant with her and led a stage. And I think she was getting in position. My belly shift. So this particular time, I better shift like that. And I knew I was not pregnant, with no baby in there.
Yes, ma'am.
Later, after that, the Lord set me free. And don't let me know that python, that snake, that's lust, the spirit of lust.
Wow.
Now, just share with us some of the things that you've been going through.
Okay. Well, let me think. Let me just put something on my body so I don't be looking exposed to everybody on online.
Right.
Yeah. So
you're at home comfortable and you just forgot to slip on something.
Yeah, because I've been here trying to clean up and stuff, you know, yes. Uh-huh. So since 2017, you know, my mom died and my husband's mom died like a week apart.
Wow.
And yes, ma'am. And I went home, you know, did the funeral, and you know, I came back, and then it's like between November and between October and November, I was at work one day, and I felt like something hit me in my right side. Just like something just hit me, and it felt like a fist was right there in that section. Jesus. And that fist would just not move, and so it's a busy time at work for us. And so, you know, I'm constantly moving because I work at a warehouse. And, you know, after that, my body just started feeling different. I just didn't feel like myself. Mm-hmm. And I'm generally a sickly type of person, you know. And I just said maybe I'm overworked. So, you know, I came home one day. And as soon as I came to my back door, I just felt my heart just started palpitating real hard. And I said to my husband, I said, I'm not feeling good. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I took a shower, I went to bed, and I was there, and I just couldn't feel right. I said, no, something is not right. I need to get myself checked out. So I went to the emergency room, and they checked me out. They said everything was fine. Mm-hmm. As soon as I came back home, the feeling came back on me again.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I told my husband, I said, something is in this house. Something not right. It's like something was just waiting on me. Just the presence was just waiting on me. It just came over me like you know, like you put, like I put on this, just something just came over me. Panic attacks, paranoid. I felt like I was going crazy, hearing voices, can't sleep. I just can't sleep. Insomnia for like 6 months. Couldn't sleep at night. 2-3 o'clock in the morning, I'd be up. I'd be on the floor rolling around. There'd be like this sound in my ear. Like you know, like you're crumpling up, you know, newspaper, you know, plastic bags. It's this sound. It's still here now, but it's not as bad as it used to be. And it's always, it's in my left ear. It's here. I think it's connected to whatever is here. It goes and it comes and it goes and it comes. And it causes, that's why, you know, it comes with a spirit of fear. It wants me to, my heart is always, you know, beating. And it's right across here, right up under my breastbone right here. And if when I touch, I can feel it pulsing. It's alive. It's pulsing. It moves. It moves from my stomach. It goes into my back. Sometimes it just like it has wings, like it spreads inside of me, like, you know, like when you're, you know, when you have that feeling, like you have this full feeling inside, like you can't breathe. That's just to me. And so I'll be in my bedroom, over in my bedroom too, and it's like a presence will just stand right on my side of the bed, just right there. So I've been going through, honey, and I had to just learn to pray, because I've gone to many different churches. I'll be honest with you, I even went to people who said they know how to do spiritual work. And it's like she was mad with me, honey. And so, oh my God, I had to repent for that. I had to repent because I was desperate. I'm not gonna lie to you. I was desperate seeking help. Desperate.
Now, when you say you were desperate seeking help, what type of help did
that's what I said. I went to spiritualists trying to get help.
So I'm gonna be a spiritualist.
Yes, I did. I did.
Was this Antoinette, was this spiritualist originally from Africa?
Ma'am, to be honest with you, this man was, I went to two people. One was from my country, and this man was from, he's Muslim. He was Muslim and doing that sort of thing. I think God was so mad with me. Instead of things getting better, things only got worse.
It got worse.
And I had to repent for that. I had to repent for that and just, you know, ask the Lord to forgive me for all of that. And so, you know, now it's just prayers and fasting. I don't do nothing like that. I don't, no, ma'am.
So let me ask you now you are in Texas. So are they calling themselves spiritualists? Because I know that particular name, they call them spiritualists.
I didn't go to anybody here in Texas. I didn't go to anybody here in Texas.
Where did you go?
I went to a friend of mine. As a matter of fact, it was a friend of mine from back home. She told me to go to this guy in Baltimore.
You mean tell me you came all the way from Texas to Baltimore to get North Carolina, and you could have made a stop right in North Carolina.
Because guess what? Lack of knowledge.
Lack of knowledge will destroy you.
I'm telling you.
Now, this person in Baltimore, they're actually calling themselves a spiritualist.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Is it a male or female?
It's a male.
Because Baltimore, wow, got a lot of warlocks and witches now in Maryland.
Yes, ma'am.
Under disguise as being a Christian.
Yeah.
We call them in America, they call themselves.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Witches.
Yes.
Warlocks.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, Cheryl, what did he have you to do? And what did he do?
He did baths on me. That's what he did.
He bathed you. Now, when he bathed you, was you completely naked?
Yes, yes.
What? Now, did your husband know about this?
No.
I feel the same. Because I know no husband want no other man to see his wife.
No.
He literally bathed you. Now, when he was bathing you, was he making any contagion, you know, chanting, anything?
You know, to be honest with you, he probably did, but I didn't know what he was saying because he was speaking in a Muslim language, let's put it that way, or whatever language he was
using.
Yes, ma'am. I don't know what he was saying. Yes, ma'am. And like I said, the Spirit of the Lord came upon me. And when I say things got bad, I mean it got bad.
It got worse because he initiated you even deeper into the kingdom of darkness.
Jesus.
That's what that spirit.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, yes. It got really bad. I went from 225 pounds down to 170 pounds. I was losing weight every day.
Jesus.
Every day. I look like I was crazy. I'm telling people would see me, and when I go to work and people would just be moving out the way. You could just tell people I looked like I was going. I'm telling you, I would go to work and I felt like somebody walking with me. Once I get to work and somebody walk into the building with me. And then another one would come home with me. And I'm telling you, I said, God, what is this? I'm telling you, I had to, I'm telling you, I know how good the goodness of God, because if it wasn't for God, I would not be here right now.
No, you've been dead. You've been dead. If it was not for the goodness of God.
The goodness of God, I'm telling you. God has allowed me to see that, you know, the enemy is a wicked thing. And, you know, it was a terrible time, because my husband he completely shut me out because his mother died. And we're still going through it right now. He just completely shut down. He wasn't paying no attention to me. I could be on the floor dying. My husband just step over me and go to bed and sleep. He just don't care.
This guy's mind locked.
Because he's going through his own situation, because my husband, he got diabetes, he got high blood pressure, he's on dialysis, it's just a lot. Yes, ma'am. And so with all of that, and then he just couldn't deal with me. He just turned it back on.
Let me ask you, Antoinette, did you and your husband take home your parents' obituaries?
If what?
Did you and your husband take home your parents' obituaries?
Yes, ma'am, they're here.
They right there, aren't they?
They're in the house, yes. Yes.
Yeah. That was the spirit who walked home with you, was spirit of death, because of those obituaries. Obituaries, that's what they are. A spirit of death is attached to obituaries.
Oh my God.
So for my mother died, I won't remember my mother as she was. I don't need that obituary reminding me of death. Because that's what obituary do. It don't remind your life. It reminds you of death. Spirit of death. So when you got those obituaries, that was a legal right that this spirit of death needed to walk right home with you and your husband. So you two have to get rid of those obituaries. And remember your parents, you know, while they was living. Because that's what I lost my mother February last year.
Yeah.
When the Lord gave me this understanding, I said, mm-mm. They even did a CD of her weight. I said, mm-mm. Yeah. I said, uh-uh.
I have that too. I have that on my
mom. I said, I didn't even watch it. I said, no, I refuse to watch it, because I won't remember my mother when she had life in her, As a matter of fact,
I'll have to go find that one for my mom and get rid of it. Now, when it comes to my husband, that's a whole different mom.
You let it stay for one for him, because he's going to have to get rid of it. As the Lord set you free, you share your testimony with him and let him know that he needs to be set free, because that spirit of death is there, as well as a spirit wife who actually is causing that sickness upon him. And Jesus, only one can heal him, and let him know that it's coming from a woman that the Lord himself healed from diabetes. You know, my kid, I was 298 about a year or so ago. My body was bloated with fluid.
Mm-hmm.
And I started having a lot of problems. A lot of problems. If you go back and look at my old videos, you will see that I was sick with, and I was going through. So by having all that fluid, I had, you know, insulin, I had diabetes, I had high blood pressure, it messed up my kidneys, but I still kept my mind focused on, look, the Lord told me, Terry, if you was not doing my work, you would have died. That's what the Lord told me, if I had not been doing his work. But I stayed faithful to God, and I got this procedure where they took the fluid out of my belly, and it was 11 pounds of fluid they took out of my belly. And when they did that, it was like the fluid in my feet, in my legs, in my knee, and in my thigh gradually left.
Wow.
And I lost over 130 some pounds, and that was fluid only.
Woo!
And when that happened, no more diabetes, no more high blood pressure. Now, my kidney is not at the level that I desire to be, but they are still functioning.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
and
ma'am.
Because I got my trust and my faith in God. So let him know that he needs to put his trust and faith in God and get delivered.
That's the problem with my husband. He don't believe in deliver. That's the thing with him.
Well, you need to show him a scripture where Jesus delivered people from demons living on the inside of them.
Amen.
They ask him, do you believe the Bible? Yeah, I believe the Bible. Well, I'm going to show the Bible where Jesus cast demons out of people.
Yes, Lord.
Mm-hmm. He cast seven out of Mary Magdalene. That's why she loved him so much.
Mm-hmm.
So show him that script. So you mean to tell me you don't believe in deliverance, casting the demon out of a person, mind, will, emotion, body, when Jesus Christ himself doing, and their aim is to kill, to steal, and to destroy.
That's it.
You need to be delivered because that spirit of death wants to take you out.
Mm-hmm.
But you keep him covered in that prayer and you share your testimony. Now, let's get back to the spiritualist. Now, did he collect any of your items or anything?
No, I didn't give him no hair or nothing like that. No, he just did the bath and gave me some herbs and things to take home with me. And I didn't even use them. I just threw them away when I got home. So
you threw them away.
Yeah, whatever he gave me, I just got rid of them. Because like I said, when I came home, all hell just broke loose in my house. And so everything that I got from him, I just got rid of it. I just put everything in the garbage and just got rid of it. That's what I did.
Now, what was his fee?
He charged me like about $500.
You pay $500 to be cursed.
Yes, ma'am.
See how you hear that? $500 to be cursed. And she happily paid $500.
Yes, I'm right about that. That's what I'm telling you. Lack of knowledge, because like I said, it was a friend of mine who said she's a Christian. She's the one who put me onto this person because I told her what was going on with
now,
me.
Now this friend, does a friend live in Baltimore too? In
yes, Maryland? Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
And she's supposed to be a Christian.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
She's a Christian witch. Yes. That's what she is.
Yeah.
She's a recruiter for the kingdom of darkness.
There you go.
So God set you free. If the Holy Ghost give you opportunity where she call you, you speak to her and let her know about the goodness of God and setting you free. And you need to tell her, girl, you need to get set free because that spirit of death is right there at your door and is going to take you out if you don't get delivered.
Jesus. Oh, God, Lord.
The spirit of death is working mightily.
Yeah.
$500 to be cursed.
Yes, ma'am.
Dear heart. Now, Antoinette, for those of you who is tuning in and wondering why Antoinette is getting this one-on-one time, because, you know, I only do group deliverance sessions now, because one-on-one session takes so much of my time, a lot of my personal time.
Thank you, Jesus.
I spend from 20 to 30 to 40 hours a week on one-on-one sessions.
Ooh, yes.
It was taking a toll on me. And plus, I have my personal life, you see.
Yes.
So I said, Lord, how can I do this thing? He said, just do group sessions. So now I do a group session, which takes way less time. But then there's some of you like Antoinette say, well, I want this one-on-one time with Evangelist King.
Yes.
The Lord told me that. Now, I don't charge for deliverance, but I do ask for a minimum donation of $50
for
a one-on-one session for my time. And everybody said, what you mean, your time? I said, my personal time.
Yes, that's true. I have no problem with that.
My personal time. I'm not charging for them for deliverance. No, it's my personal time. And the Lord gave me to go ahead to do so. I won't be wrong from doing this for my personal time. Because a lot of you are wasting my time. I schedule a one-on-one session with you, and you don't even show up. That's wasting my time.
That's right.
And plus, now, just because you tune into my program, it's free. You have an opportunity to listen and to see. Well, it costs me.
Yes, it do.
It may be free to you, but it's not free to me. It costs me. So those minimum donations here. And one brother said, well, why don't you let people give? I've been doing this for a mighty long time, and people just don't give. They make promises.
They don't come through.
But praise God for the very few who do give. Thank God.
That's right. Amen.
But I don't know why Christians think that they're supposed to receive everything free from other Christians.
Yes, ma'am.
And that's not true. And look at Antoinette. Pay that man $500 for his time to curse her.
Yep.
And God wants to use his time to bless her. So go to the website at radio.holyghostfire.us for instructions on how to tune in or request a deliverance session. You can request a a group session, which requires no minimum suggested donation, to just send me an email for that request. Okay. But a one-on-one time where you want my personal time, you know, to go in depth and talk about these things, then yes, there's a minimum donation of $50, and I'm a choice of my time. Okay. So Antoinette, let's get to the root of this thing.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Because what is happening now is only stemmed from the root call.
Yes.
There's a spirit husband. Have you ever seen that this spirit in a dream or even physically?
You know what?
I've not
seen it, but there was a time before I actually felt anything moving in my body. Mm-hmm. I would wake up feeling like I'm having an orgasm, but I've never felt like anybody laying. I've not felt anybody laying up on me, you know, nothing like that. But in my dream, I would wake up feeling myself having an orgasm.
Ooh, and that spirit. Yeah.
Yeah. But after this thing started to move, I have not felt that. But sometimes I can feel down in that area, like, you know, like movement, like you want to come on to me. But I pray about it. I ask the Lord to cover me. I say, God, cover me under the blood of Jesus. Let nothing touch me in my, you know, I speak about it to God. So I don't know if it's going on in my dream, and I don't know, but I know. Not really.
That's how they trick a person, because a person look at it as a dream. Maybe it didn't happen. No, it did happen. It's that spirit.
If God
open your spirit, your eyes, you'll see this hideous demon thing right there with you, having sex with you, letting out this terrible sound. You know, because masturbation is that demon spirit's orgasm. Ugh.
Yes.
Okay, this spirit that was espoused to you, it came to you as a little girl, unaware. Now, molestation, the simplest term where you can understand, because a person immediately think about a penetration. Oh, no, I've never been molested. Oh, because I've never been penetrated. That's the advanced step or stage to molestation. But molestation is, as a child, you come into the knowledge of knowing about sex. And it's not your time. That means that child had been molested. That's molestation.
Okay.
Because there's a time for everything. Now, when a child, or how do demons deceive a child? Some of the ways is, especially love mom and dad game. Let's play house. You know. To the child, it's innocent, but it's not. They're naive about what really goes on between mom and dad.
Yeah.
And that's why when they first start playing mom and dad games, they find themselves getting on top of one another, fondling each other, kissing each other. Mm-hmm. And then sometimes, as a child, you come across pornographic material. And sometimes, you know, you may hear grown-ups, the parents or someone else, having sex, or you may have seen them. And that's how these spirits would enter through the ears and through the eye, and that in molestation. So now, the Lord did tell me when I bring this up that the Holy Ghost will always bring back to that person remembering, because these devils, they'll suppress that memory.
Yes.
Because they know that if the person remembered the memory, they would become exposed. And once they are exposed, light exposed them, they got to go. If ands or buts about, they got to go. So that's why they try to keep it a secret. You know, don't tell anybody. It's all a dirty little secret, you see.
Mm-hmm.
So you was a little girl when you came into the knowledge of knowing about sex, you were molested. Now, what gives them the legal right to attack the little children is because of sins of the parents. Mm-hmm. The parents have rejected Jesus as their Savior and Lord. So don't have no spiritual covering.
Yeah.
So if the parents don't have no spiritual covering, God had given parents as a covering to their children. Well, the children don't have no spiritual covering. So that's why it's so easy for demons to attack and work in a child's mind, and then get in the mind, get down into their heart, because of the sins of the parent. So just, if you have the name, do not share the name, but share that your age and how Satan deceived you and coming to the knowledge of sex when you were a little girl.
Well, like you said, you know, I've had, you know, thinking back on my childhood where I've played house, you know, quite a few times with girls, with boys. I remember one time that I was even kissing a girl, you know.
Woo, that was that spirit right there. That was that spirit.
Yeah, kissing a little girl. I remember that. Mm-hmm. You know, so I was young then, maybe like 6, 7, somewhere there, you know. Mm-hmm. And so I mean, you know, and when you come from the Caribbean, you're exposed to witchcraft, you know, and you mm-hmm. don't know being exposed mm-hmm. to witchcraft. We, mm-hmm. we are deep in religion and stuff like that, and you know, mm-hmm. You know, things that your grandma used to do, and you know, stuff like things of tradition. Mm-hmm. Let's put it that way. Mm-hmm. So I really can't tell you exactly when, but you know, I've been exposed to stuff like that. I have. Now that mm-hmm. I'm older, I look back.
Mm-hmm. Round 7 is when you were exposed to playing house, mom and dad. Yeah, sexual demons. They come in a cluster, in a bundle. Mm. And when you get one, you get them all. So you got the spirit husband, spirit wife. You got incubus and succubus. These are sexual demons that mainly attack the single people. And once succubus and incubus does what they need to do, then that's when spirit husband, spirit wife takes over. Mm. Also included in the group is incest, homosexuality, bestiality, and lesbianism. Mm. So when you get one, you get them all.
Right.
You get them all. And the such thing is get one and not all. When you get them all, because it comes in a bundle, a cluster.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's why you found yourself kissing that little girl, because that mm-hmm. spirit had already entered you. Mm-hmm. And you know, again, Jesus said the aim is only to kill, to steal, and destroy. Mm-hmm. And to keep one from being successful in their destiny in Christ Jesus. Because if we're not successful in our destiny in Christ Jesus, we're not going to be successful here on earth.
Right. Mm-hmm. But I haven't indulged in any of that, like, no lesbianism since I've been, you know, since I'm grown and I know myself. That was the only occasion I remember doing that.
But right. Just because that was not your will, you knew it was wrong. But that spirit is still in there.
Yeah.
Now, if you had never gotten delivered into that, you found yourself eventually going in that direction.
Wow.
I see that spirit all on you, in you. That spirit is there. Okay? Mm. I see that spirit in a lot of women, Christian women, who never been delivered. Because I'm telling you, when you get one sexual demon, you get them all.
Yes.
But you were never delivered. That means those demons, spirit husband, who's a strong man, and the leader.
I get the leader.
Mm-hmm. You catch the leader out, the others gonna follow, because they depend on the leader. I don't have to call out different names, just target the strong man.
Yes.
The spirit husband. And then I spoil his good. They got to go. Don't let devil deceive you. Well, maybe could, like I got several email, they say, well, can it be more than one strong man? I said, no, there's only one leader. No such thing. Mm-hmm. One leader. Always one leader. You got no two leaders. One.
Oh, yeah.
The main person.
Yes.
That's who you copy.
So my husband got a spirit wife and I got a spirit husband. What is this?
Yeah. That's because you've never been delivered. You've never been delivered. That means that now when you came to Jesus Christ, Antoinette, it was your spirit that was connected to the Lord, because his Holy Spirit is his DNA. Born of God.
Yes.
Connected to God. Came alive in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
No more dead. No more living in the land of zombies, the walking dead. When we first come to us, our spirit that is quickened and made alive in Christ Jesus.
Yes, ma'am.
Connected to our Heavenly Father. But we are more than a spirit.
Mm.
Remember that. Me and you, we are spirit. I don't see you. You don't see me. We just see each other's body.
The body
for this earth. Now, within our body, we have a soul. That soul is the mind, the will, and our emotions.
Ah, okay.
You get it? Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
Ma'am.
You know, we are three in one. Mm. So when we first come to the Lord, it's our spirit that is birthed, born to the family of God, made new. But your soul, your mind, will, and body is not new. You got the same soul and the same body. And those devils that was in your soul realm, in your body before your spirit was born again, is still there. A lot of people, when they leave the altar and they go back home, they fall right back into sin. And they wonder, well, why? I just gave my life to the Lord. Why I'm going back into this scene?
Right.
And they get discouraged and say, forget it. And continue to live in sin. That's because in their soul realm, in their body, the devils are still there.
Yes.
Now, Jesus Christ delegated his authority to his body on earth.
Yes.
Those who believe in his name, oh, they believe in his name. And they do as he did. They say what he said. He said, I have given you authority and power over all the power of the enemy in my name. You shall cast devils out. Devils out of where? Out of the soul realm and out of the body. Because we are his body on earth.
Right.
So he does nothing that his body on earth does not do because he delegated that authority. No employer is going to do a supervisor job because the employer delegated his authority to that supervisor.
Right.
So that's the reason why come you, me, and all of us, when we first came to Jesus Christ and the person who was naive concerning the knowledge of God, the word of God, did not confront the devils in our soul realm, in our body.
Right.
The devils are still there.
Yeah, because I was thinking that once you give your life to Christ, then, you know,
We was taught that. That's what we was taught.
That's right.
We taught that, and that's what we believe. But that's not so. I'm telling you, that's why a lot of people, you know, after they gave life to Jesus Christ and went back home, they continued to sin, and they tried to stop, but they couldn't. And they gave up. They said, what's the point? And they just gave Satan a total will. Why? Because devils were still in their soul realm, in their body. They've been cast out by a servant of the Most High God who believed. Because Jesus delegated authority to his body on earth.
Amen.
But praise God, the Lord said, when you seek me with all your heart, I allow you to find me. We seek the Lord with all our heart entering. He said, I let you find me. So I now got to clean up my daughter. I got to clean up my son. I'm going to send you your human helper. He sent me to my human helper. Praise the living God. And through his servant, he cast those devils out of my soul, my mind, emotion, and out of my body. They came out.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Now, you have to receive by faith in his word that he's going to do that.
Yes, ma'am.
You don't go by your five senses. As he do this thing, because the devil is very sneaky, Antoinette. Mm-hmm. Now, he knew that you knew that he was in you based on the movements in your body. So now you deliver. Jesus delivered you. So you say, well, there should be no movements in my body. And that is true. And the devil knows that. But you know what the devil tried to do? Now, he has some power. He uses a little power to make you think that you got moving in your body. That you can say, so you can believe with your mind and say out your mouth, that spirit didn't leave. Because I still feel it in my body. And once you say that, you know what's going to happen?
Come right back in.
It's coming in you, and seven more demons, but stubborn and wicked than the first demon is entering you as well. Why? Because you did not receive what God done for you by faith alone in his word that he did. You're going by your five senses. When the Lord delivered me into that, I felt when that spirit came out of my mouth. It hit the sides of my mouth. The side of my mouth went coming out. I felt that.
Wow.
And I didn't know what it was until I asked the Lord. The Lord told me it was a demon. I said, what? But did you not know I never looked at that as my evidence that I was set free by me feeling that thing coming out of my mouth? I never looked at that as my evidence that I was set free. I only looked at my faith in his word that he set me. He said, go to the woman of God. She's going to lay hands on you. That was his word.
Wow.
And he set me free. So my faith was always in his word that he set me free, not in the evidence that I felt that thing when it went out my mouth. I never said, I know I'm free because I felt that thing when it came out my mouth. I never said that, never thought that. No, my faith was in his word.
Amen.
That's what you have to do, because devils will play tricks on you like that.
Yes, ma'am.
So you can open the door and let them in through unbelief and doubt. What you do when the devil plays little games like that after delivering, you say, no! I rebuke that lying feeling. You are not in me. You're on the outside of me trying to get in. I rebuke you in Jesus' name. Get away from me. Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Burn, burn, burn. Go crazy, girl.
Oh!
You go crazy, girl. And then you say, thank you, Father, for setting me free.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Because they're stubborn spirits, and you be stubborn too. Your lying illusion. Holy Ghost, get. Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire. Girl, they are going crazy. They're running back. Woo, they're running back in terror. Don't you have to do that? You don't do this. You don't go to your computer, find my email, say, Evangelist King, I think one is in me because I felt blah, 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 blah. Oh, girl, you just messed up. That demon jumped right back into you with seven demons. Wicked than they see. That's the wrong thing to do. Even in the dream, they'll try to come back in the dream. And her spirit will wake you up. And you say, oh, Deborah, that dream is from you. I rebuke that dream in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Yeah. And then you say, Father, thank you for setting me free. Then that dream, you remember no more. You don't even talk about it. You don't share it with nobody. Forget about that dream. Don't be sending me an email about that dream either. Because they're telling me that you remember that dream. You just messed up. Just forget. Mm-hmm. The devil texted me.
I recently had a dream. And I had a dream that I was back home. And I was walking with my father. And I could hear, like, people were being hit with missiles. I just see who they were. I just hear them, like things were just passing me by. Mm. Nothing hit my daddy. They were passing me, and we went into the house, and I'm saying to myself, those were weapons, but I just don't know what they were. But God covered me and my father. Absolutely nothing. I was in the house here, people screaming and crying, and people just being hit by stuff, and I couldn't see what it was.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you went in a dream with your father, were you in Jamaica?
Yeah, the dream was back home.
Back home. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's Lord showing you the spiritual wickedness.
Yes.
In high places in that air because of witchcraft. And
yes,
Satan just destroying people like this. Just like a nuclear weapon, it destroys.
Yeah.
So that symbolizes how destruction of the enemy is killing your people.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, if you look at them in the natural, they look like they're fine. But they're not in the spirit realm. They're amongst the walking dead. They are zombies. But God was protecting you.
Yes, he was. Yes, he was. Father,
because of your prayers, he was protecting
Yes,
I'm telling you, girl, we'll be surprised. Even right now, you sit in your home, I'm sitting in my home. If the Lord was open by spiritual eyes, we'd be like, because we'll be shocked of that spiritual battle that's around us and the angels are holding back those forces.
Now,
I was a little girl.
I know.
And I spent the night with my uncle because I thought his wife, but I found out that his girlfriend had a sister around my age. And we played all day and she asked me to spend the night. I said, okay. So I spent the night with her. I think I probably around 8, 9, something like that, 10. I spent the night with her over my uncle's house. Well, I woke up to this terrible banging and sound. Oh, it was like, I said, things. They don't know about no demons. I always said things.
Yeah.
They was banging on the wall. They made such a terrible sound. And I knew they wanted me and that little girl. They wanted her. And they was going crazy. The sound I heard, they was going crazy. And I knew if they was forgotten us, girl, they would have just put our fingers off, our hands, our legs. And they would just brutalize us. I knew that as a little girl. And I was so scared, I had a cover over my head. And that sound, oh. And I remember this man was standing over me, and I wasn't afraid of this man. Now I knew it was my guardian angel. And this man said, fear not.
Ooh,
I'm here to protect you. I said, yeah, but they want us. And I had a cover over my head, but I could see through the cover, and I could see the front door. Now, the front door was, though, it was about this wide open. Like somebody was trying to force their way in, but there was somebody that was holding the door where they couldn't come in. That's what I said. And the angel, the man, as a little girl, I said the man, but it was an angel. Mm-hmm. said, mm-hmm. you don't have to be afraid. But girl, I was so afraid because of that heating. I mean, them things were going crazy.
I know, girl.
And so when I woke up the next morning, and the front door was open, and something had went on with the neighbor across the street. I said, across the hallway. I said, oh no, them things got hurt. As a little girl, I never knew what happened to the neighbor, but there was police officers and stuff like that. But as a little girl, I said, oh, them things got hurt.
Mm-mm.
That's what I said. But I didn't stay at my uncle no more. So when I got older, the Holy Spirit brought it back to my remembrance. I said, Lord, what was going on? He said, because Terry, your uncle was involved in witchcraft. I said, what? Yeah, it was all in the drawers. Witchcraft. The witchcraft world. And so I asked my mother, she said, oh yeah, just like his dad. Mm. I never stayed with them again. But I'm sharing it to tell everybody. We'll actually be surprised what's going on in the spirit realm. But God has got us covered. He got us protected.
Yes, he do. Yes, he do.
And we got to stay
I'm living proof of that because, you know, like I said, there was a time I felt like I would be going to the asylum because everybody thought I was going crazy. When I'm telling them that all this stuff is happening to me, nobody believed me.
Because it was having a spirit. See, they only see in the physical, everything looked calm and peace and cool. But no. This thing in the spirit.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I remember, you know, when the Holy Ghost first began to teach me about spiritual warfare. He said, I'm going to teach you about spiritual warfare because I didn't know about demons. I didn't know they exist. So the Holy Spirit had to teach me. He said, I got you covered.
Mm.
He said, but I'm going to let you feel them trying to grab you. But they can't. It's like when they grab, it's like their hand go through. But I'm going to let you feel it. And the Holy Spirit did. And I can literally, it depends on where I go. Like when I went to Africa, in Kenya, 2008, and went to the market, and in the market they got witch doctors there selling their paraphernalia and stuff like that. Girl, when I went there, I could literally feel the infestation of demons.
Ooh.
But the Lord said, I sent you here to enjoy yourself. Mm. I got you covered. I said, yes, Lord. And I had this big smile on my face, but as I went, I could feel.
Yes.
I could feel those demons trying to grab me, but they couldn't. Like, they couldn't get that grip. Why? Because there was no sin in me. See, Satan only grabs sin. He only grabs darkness when it's in you. They couldn't. But the Holy Spirit let me feel that. I said, wow, this place is infested with demons. But I had this great smile on my face.
Even
when I came to the witch doctor selling that paraphernalia, I just smiled. Because I knew they couldn't touch me. No demon couldn't touch me.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't dwell on that spiritual warfare, that spiritual battle. Because I trust the Lord's word. He said, I sent you to enjoy yourself. The goodness of Africa. And not only Africa now, I mean, you can, like you went to Baltimore, you go to New York. Now, there are certain states that are more demon possessed than other states. And Baltimore, Maryland, it began to be just like New York.
Jesus.
In the spirit realm. Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Florida, you too, Florida. Miami. Out to California, you want to go to those big cities. Who you thinking is pulling you to those big cities?
Them demons.
They are water spirits. They are demons. Sexual demons pulling you to come to those big cities. But anyway.
I'm not a friend that lives down there in North Carolina. She moved down there from New York. She moved to a place called Hamlet.
Yeah, Hamlet. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, that place is in North Carolina. Very, very demonized. And these are little towns. Like in my hometown, Goldsboro. It's a little town.
Yeah.
But there's a witch coven in Goldsboro.
Lord Jesus.
One of the witches coven out in California have an office. A coven group in Goldsboro, that little town.
Wow.
They also target the little towns too. Not just the big towns, but the little towns too.
Mm.
Yeah.
All I know,
Hamlet is one of those towns.
Wow.
Yeah. But because of Revolutionary Wars that was fought in North Carolina.
Yeah, because I went to Virginia and I felt it was so depressing to me spiritually when I went there. It just felt like stuff was just dragging me down, just dragging. I said, no, I can't stay here. I said, no, this place has no life in it. It mm-hmm. just had this dead feeling to me, just dead. And I went there one time, and I've not been back. I did not enjoy it. I went to Virginia, it's not Virginia Beach, Charleston. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It just had a dead feeling. Yes, ma'am.
Well, God going to set you totally free because you seek him. Now, again, you have to believe he's going to do that. And how to maintain your deliverance is submitting to God's word and believing that when the Son of Man sets you free, you are totally free and free indeed.
Yes.
There's no ifs, ands, buts about it.
Yes, okay? Ma'am.
And the Holy Spirit will teach you how to continue in your deliverance. You have to maintain it.
How do you get the Holy Spirit, though? Because recently I found myself...
Well, you already got them. See, that's what I feel. These teachings have screwed up God's children's mind. You already have the Holy Spirit. When you first asked the Lord to come into your heart, how do you think he came? He came by the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit came, made his abode in your spirit. In
Amen.
You have him. Now he wants us, completely us. We have him, but he wants to have completely us. Like the Lord said, Terry, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. I literally was shocked when the Lord told me he had some of me, not all of me. I was like,
wow.
And he did not. He didn't have my soul. He didn't have my body. Why? Because devils were living there. Because he don't coexist with demons, you see.
Yes. So,
the Holy Spirit made his abode in you when you received Jesus, asked Jesus to come into your heart to live his life in you, in your spirit. He did. You have him. He's in you.
Yes,
he leads you to all truth. Why do you think you're talking to me? He's the one who led you to this truth.
Amen.
The demon spirit snake and Jezebel, as well as spirit husband, who led you to that false prophet.
Yes.
In other words, to initiate you deeper and further into dark. But the grace of God said, no, you should not have her.
That's right.
I thank God for battling for us. He battles for our soul.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
Yes, now, he does. Now, in order for the Holy Spirit to completely have you as your deliverer, you have to keep pursuing the Lord with all your might.
Yes, ma'am.
He comes first in everything.
Yes, ma'am.
You consume the Lord's word.
Yes, ma'am.
Consume it.
Yes.
Every day.
Every
continuously.
Day.
And as you consume his word, who is Jesus Christ himself, next thing you know, you're going to feel the Holy Ghost on the inside of you.
Hey.
Bubbling up like a well of fresh spring water that's coming from your spell. You never feel this refreshing. You're like, a cool sensation.
What is that?
Well, that's the Holy Spirit in you manifesting himself.
Hallelujah.
Making his presence known. Coming up. And that thing you know, he got all of you.
Wow.
You are completely submerged in him.
Yes.
No longer do you have him, but now he have you. And the evidence of that, you begin to speak in this funny language.
Yes.
You'd be like, what is it? That's your spirit language.
Yes.
Where you talk to your heavenly father, that he's a spirit.
Yes.
See, that's the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence speaking in unknown tongues. It's not a language that is known in the world that can be interpreted.
Right.
It's not the gift of diversities of tongue, like a lot of people think it is. That's totally different. Now, this is your heavenly language in which you commune with your heavenly father.
Amen.
And you ain't the same. And now, girl, you're in a position where God can use you now.
Hey.
See, now, we are so used to demons manifesting through us, making their presence known. But it's the Holy Spirit in us who wants to manifest and make his presence known.
That's right.
And how we know when it's the Holy Spirit is we read about the nine gifts, which are the manifestation of the Holy Spirit.
Right.
You see. And when he come up upon us that way, it's for one reason, and that is for service.
Yes.
God's service.
Yes, ma'am.
And giving glory to Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Of Jesus Christ. That's why we can't claim the manifestation of the Holy Spirit. We can't claim it as our gift. I have the gift of healing. I have a gift of diversity of tongue, the interpretation of tongue, the word of wisdom, word of knowledge. I have that gift. No. These are the Holy Spirit manifestation.
That's right.
His manifestation. And he said, at his will, he chose whoever he decided to choose to manifest himself through.
That's right.
But what we need to do is get more knowledge about who the Holy Spirit is.
Right.
And how he manifests through the gift or the manifestation of the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
And that way we are designed spiritual gift. And then we end up being a perfect candidate for the Holy Spirit to use us.
And bring right. Yes, ma'am.
But literally, the Holy Ghost is in you, in us all. That's how we became born again. Okay. Mm-hmm. He's in us. He just won't. Us to be totally submerged in him for God's service.
That's right.
All right?
Yes, ma'am.
I got on my YouTube channel, I got a teaching series on the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit and his gift that Kenneth Hagin did many years ago.
Oh, okay.
I have the manual, and I use that manual to do that video teaching. So just go to my YouTube channel. And key in.
I will.
The Holy Spirit series. It should come up. Because that's because after the Lord led me to Kenneth Hagin teaching, and I went through it because I didn't believe it. I didn't believe in speaking in tongues because I had an aunt who was a witch.
Oh.
She went to a church and she was speaking in tongues, and the people just loved her. And I'm a little 8-year-old girl looking at it. And I would say, don't you know she's a witch? She's in the witchcraft. And that, like that woman was a servant of the Most High God.
Right? Wow.
I counted. I looked at all tongues as being of the devil. And the Lord had to correct me using his word.
Wow.
I came a believer. He said, if there's a counterfeit, there must be a real thing, Terry. I said, sure.
Yeah.
So I said, Lord, if this is something that I need, then so be it.
Yeah.
God sent me to his servant. And that's why I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and speaking in tongues. And that's another testimony. That series, part 19, I share my testimony about that, my personal testimony about that. But I just want you to know that the Holy Ghost is in you. Don't think he's not in you. He is in you. What you're talking about is that you've been completely in the Holy Ghost.
Yes, yes.
Just like you got a glass of water. Like this glass right here, I could fill this glass with water.
Right.
That water represents the Holy Ghost.
Right.
In okay. But if I take this glass and sit it in the sink, stop at the sink, sit it in the sink with a faucet on and keep running water, keep running water, keep running water, what will happen? Well, no longer will just the water be in the glass. Now the glass is in the water.
Right.
You see, so the Holy Ghost just don't want to be in us, but he wants us to be completely submerged in him.
Amen.
So that makes us ready to do God's service.
That's right. That's right.
So, Antoinette, God's going to set you totally free. Now, you see the advantage of these one-on-one sessions, you get more in-depth.
Yes, ma'am. That's why I pay for it, because I know the Spirit of the Lord is able to do all things, but you know, for my situation, I would much prefer to be in this type of situation where I can speak to you without any distraction, like you said, and you know, let you focus on what I'm saying, and I can hear what you're saying. Yes, ma'am.
Again, dear heart, I'm not that $50 suggested donation is not
a choice
to be delivered. It's for my personal time, because I'm telling you, I one-on-one session takes up a lot of time. Now, for instance, the last group delivery session I think I had about 14 attendees.
Woo!
So if you would, every one-on-one session takes at least an hour. Sometimes it can go on to an hour and a half. I have them to not go on 2 hours. But just think, 14. So you're looking at over 20 hours.
Yes.
20 to 30 hours.
And it's just you.
if I did one-on-one session with each one of them.
No. It's just you. Yes.
Right. Now that required a lot of my time.
Yes.
A lot of my personal time. Now, the group session only took 3 hours.
Ah!
20 to 30 hours took 3 hours.
Amen.
It's not good. So Lord said, no, Terry, it's not wrong for you to offer your time.
Yes, ma'am.
Because if you want to be a group session with no suggested donation, feel free. But again, yeah. Now the reason why I'm doing this because there was those that were, this is their request. They wanted one-on-one time.
Right.
You see, I said, well, Lord, right. They're going to give a donation.
Right.
Because I have to pay for these programs.
Right. I tried to get onto the prayer line, but for some reason I was online Sunday night because when I saw you, I was listening on the phone Sunday night with this lady from Africa.
You know what? A couple more people said somebody. I think that's an old number, and somebody else got. But actually, the prayer line you're talking about is Shalom Morning Prayer. That's a corporate right. prayer. That's corporate prayer.
Oh, corporate prayer.
That's
oh.
corporate prayer. It's not a prayer where I pray for one's deliverance.
Okay. Okay. But I heard your voice. It was you I heard talking to this lady. Yes. A 713 number. You were talking to her. I tell her about
it. Do me a favor, Antoinette. After yes. we hang up, send me the link so I can see what you're talking about. Because I had so many people who said
I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything. I just heard it because you was telling her that she had dreads, that she was saying she was growing her hair. She had dreads. And you told her to cut off the dread that you know. You said you give her somebody else's number to call for her to get a person's testimony because that person had dreads. You told that person about locks.
Right. I remember things like that. Well, I'm curious about if you know how you got hooked up to it.
I have a phone number. I can send you the phone number that I called and I was able to get on and hear you talking to the lady.
You know, I wonder, you know what? You calling Deliverance Radio.
Yes, that was it. That was it.
That's Deliverance Radio. That's not a live program.
That was it. Yes, ma'am. That was it. Sunday night. Okay. I heard it.
That's Deliverance Radio. That's not a live program.
That's
a 24/7 internet radio program.
That's what I heard. That's what it is.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. That's what it is. Yes, ma'am.
Praise the living God. Well, Jesus, we just thank you. Now, you know Jesus here with us. He said, when there are even two of us come together in his name, the Father is right here with us. He's with us. And those demons in you are screaming because they know they got to go. Dear heart, demons do not want to be confronted. Do you not know demons don't care about you praying for the person? You've been prayed for many times, Antoinette. Don't care about you being prayed for. They just don't want to be confronted and cast out what they say their house.
Yes, yes.
They
yes,
claim
yes.
you as their house. As long as they're not confronted, they say they is at peace and in peace.
That's right.
Matter of fact, when you just pray for a person, demons are right there listening. Mm-hmm. They hear how you're praying. But also, they know that you're not a threat because you refuse to confront them. And you don't pray to the Lord to cast them out. Just like if you're a supervisor, you don't go to your superior and say, well, you go supervise Antoinette, because she's misbehaving.
Yes.
You know, then the person can look at that supervisor like, what?
Mm-hmm.
No, I told you to do it.
Yes.
So we don't pray to our Heavenly Father to cast devils out of person. He told us to confront them in Jesus' name and to command them to come out.
Mm-hmm.
So they do not want to be confronted. They don't want you to go to an anointed, appointed servant of God.
There you go. That's it.
Who believe in the word of God. Who believe God.
There you go. You said the right word there. Appointed. A lot of people are self-appointed. They're not God-appointed.
Right. God. See, this work that I do, I'm not doing this because it's something I decided to do. Oh, right. I would have never started doing it. Matter of fact, Jesus told me to do it, but he didn't tell me I would be confronting stronghold. He said, Terry, this was in 2012. Make the ministry phone number available because my children is crying out for deliverance. I want to set them free. I said, yes, Lord. So I started doing that. But then I noticed, Antoinette, there was a pattern. I said, hold up, Jesus, there's a pattern here. Why is it that I'm confronting a stronghold spirit lover, spirit spouse? He's because that is the stronghold. He said, that's because many years ago in the church, that's one subject they failed to teach my children.
Yes.
Sex. They kept it covered.
Yes.
And Satan had deceived my children regarding that because they were not given the proper instructions about sex.
Yes.
And that's the main area that my children are in bondage to this day and time. I said, okay, Lord. And so, Antoinette, I would confront that spirit and cast the spirit out by faith.
Amen.
There was no manifestation. I left that way. By faith, I knew they left. By faith.
Yes. Jesus.
And so I would encourage the person to receive by faith because I knew they was gone.
Yes, Lord.
And I guess, Antoinette, I guess I was getting too used to that method. No manifestation. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So Farrah is from Haiti.
Ah!
Her parents, especially her grandparents, her grandmother and mother, was voodoo priestess, and she was dedicated to Satan.
Ooh.
To be a bride of Satan.
Jesus.
So here I went through my routine, right? So when it got down to confronting the spirit, and I started my five prayers, Antoinette, it was less than 2 minutes.
What?
I think Jezebel manifested first.
Woo!
Perfect English. Now, Farrah, when she spoke with that Haitian accent. It was always hard for me to understand. I had to listen very hard. But when Jezebel came on her, that English was perfect. That's how I knew it was Farrah.
Yes.
And this thing started bragging about what it was going to do to Farrah. She was not going to Haiti. She was not changing Haiti. Why should she? It just kept on and on. And I heard and I listened to the Holy Spirit. And it shocked me because I never had that manifestation. And I was like, oh God, I looked around. Nobody's in here but me. I said, ain't nobody here. I said, come on, pray with me. I didn't have that. Lord, he said, don't converse with it. Continue with the fire prayer. I said, yes, Lord. Now, the Lord told me not to converse with it. Now, is it wrong to converse with them? It's only wrong when the Holy Spirit did not tell you to converse with things.
That's right.
That's when it's wrong. Because remember, Jesus did converse with Legion. What's your name?
Yes.
The Lord said, don't converse with it. That thing kept on and on and on. I kept on the fire prayer. I kept on. And then, I think Satan baby manifested. Snake manifested. Especially that Jezebel. It was.
Woo!
I kept on with the five prayers. I refused to, and it carried on that conversation, girl. I kept on with them five prayers. Got so hot. Jezebel said, oh, it's getting hot in here. I can't stand this spot. I got to go. And I kept on.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
I'm a saying snake. I kept on. It finally had to leave.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
They all left. I mean, it's recorded. I got it on YouTube. It's recorded.
That's right. I know they're real. As I said, because like I'm saying, somebody see me outside and I don't tell them what's going on with me. They don't think nothing is wrong with me.
No, because you look fine. Like Farrah looked fine.
Yeah.
Just like with Farrah. Farrah was tormenting her so much.
I'm telling you.
She called this ending, and I'm not calling the ministry name. Everybody loved this ministry. Love it.
Yes.
Called this international ministry number. Said, I need deliverance from the spirit that is in me. It's talking to me. But do you know they referred her to the psychic war?
Yes, ma'am. I believe.
You'd be surprised if I called that ministry, but I ain't gonna call that ministry.
I went to the doctor. They gave me pills to sleep, pills for anxiety, pills for everything. And a man of God looked at me and said to me, if you don't listen to nothing else I tell you, stop taking them pills.
Yeah,
that's part of witchcraft. He said that's part of witchcraft. That's what he told me. And let me tell you, when I stopped taking them pills, I would be so, I couldn't sit still. I'd just be pacing. I'd be walking up and down. I'd just be moving. I'd just be on the floor rolling like a ball because I just didn't know what to do with myself. I had to cry out to God. I had to cry out.
I understand because when I was going through that sickness, Antoinette, with all that water in my body, I could not sleep. And I remember going 2 or 3 days without sleep. And it was like, I was like, there's a Lord help me. And I hear the devil say, tell your doctor to get some sleep. I said, I will not. I don't know what makes it work. I tell you, that was a test. Without sleep, 2 and 3 days.
Yes,
I kept on and kept on. I said, no, I would not. And I said, Lord, Father, thank you for blessed sleep. Thank you, Lord. And I would like to be so sleepy, but I couldn't go to sleep. I know after processing time, probably 6 months or so.
I would sit in this chair you see me sitting in trying to go to sleep, and like somebody would come and actually touch me and wake me up like, no sleep.
No sleep. That is insomnia is a demon spirit. Insomnia is a demon spirit. And that spirit attacked me. I said, no.
Yes.
And the doctor wanted me, said, well, maybe you should get a, what's that test? A sleep apnea test. I said, no.
Yeah.
I said, no. I worked in that department at Johns Hopkins before. I said, no. No sleep apnea. He put in my chart, she refused sleep. I said, no, because I knew it was a demon spirit. If I got that sleep apnea test, would happen was that was an open door for that demon spirit of insomnia to enter me.
In a
word. I said,
that's what bothers me, And it still comes upon me every once in a while. I be up all night. I got to get up 4 o'clock to go to work. And every Friday night, every Friday night, I cannot sleep.
Mm-hmm. It's a spirit.
All night. Because the attack on me is when I'm here in the house. And when I go to work, them two places, work and home. Work and home.
It's a spirit deal.
When I'm somewhere else, it don't bother me that much. But once I'm in here, and once I go to work.
It's a demon spirit.
Yes, ma'am.
I refuse. I said, no. I said, you're not coming into me now. And again, my eyes like this. I said, thank you, Father, for blessing sleep. And I'm like, this.
three days.
My eyes like this. Thank you, Father. And at the same time, I'm still doing the work of the Lord.
Amen.
Still doing the work of the Lord, you see.
Yeah.
But God, he delivered me.
I'm telling you. Because, how I know this thing is a snake, I can feel it. It just wraps itself around, right up under my breastbone. It is just laid up right here. When I put my hand right here, I can feel it pulsing. It moves. It does, like a cobra would just rise up. It just opens. And my whole body, it just be vibrating. My whole body just be shaking, And my husband is just laying over, sleeping like nothing ain't going on. I'm telling you. And this crack in my ear, as soon as I get close to my husband, it gets louder. I can't go nowhere near my husband in the bed.
Oh, that spirit wife don't want you to sleep with her. I'm going to share this here with me, then we're going to get to you. Now, this is before I knew about spirit spouses.
Yes,
and this was many, many years ago. Children was young. I'm in the bed with my husband, and my back was towards him. And he would take his shoulder and hunch me in my back. And I'd be like, why Roger hit me in my back with his shoulder like that? And I'm like, dude, why he keep? I'd be saying in my mind, why he keep doing that? Why he keep doing that? So the next night he did the same thing, and I said the same thing. The third night. I guess the Lord got tired of me asking why Roger keep hitting me in my back with his elbow. So that third night is what said, turn around. So I turned around. When I turned around, I turned back around and said, help me, Jesus. I saw it was not my husband who was hunting me in my back. It was that spirit wife. I saw that spirit.
What?
Scared me, girl. I said, help me, Jesus. And Lord said, that's who hunting you in your back. It's not right.
Jesus.
And that spirit did not want you to sleep with him. And the Holy Spirit brought to my remembrance. He said, Terry, he said, now you knew about you knew your great grandmother. I said, yeah. He said, now wasn't your great grandmother and your great-granddad in separate rooms? I said, yeah. He said, now, your grandmother, wasn't your grandmother and your step grandfather in separate rooms? I said, yeah. He said, your mother. Didn't your mother and your stepfather eventually end up in separate rooms? I said, yeah. He said, that spirit wants you to be in a separate room than your husband. I said, that's a lie. That is a liar. Mm-mm. I said, no. Spirit wife, I said, you're not taking me out of my bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Like you took my grandparents out of their beds.
Yeah.
I said, no, in Jesus' name, this is a fight. No.
Yes.
You know, I'd be wake up a lot of time, put my hand on my husband, I'd be praying for him. I pray for him.
Yeah. Yes.
I said, no. Now, when I got sick, it was totally different because I didn't want to keep him up. So I went in a different room because he had to work. That was different. Yes. But for that spirit to run me out of my marital bed, I said, no.
Yeah.
I refused. I said, no. This is my husband.
Yeah.
And I would pray for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Lord.
That's what I told my husband, because if you tell my husband about a spiritcraft right now, he'll probably look at me like I'm super crazy. He would just fall out. Like, what? Who?
You pray for me. Matter of fact, what you do, Andrew, you say, Father in Jesus' name.
Father Jesus.
Let my husband see that spirit wife.
Let my husband. There you go. Yes, ma'am. I will say.
Men are more stubborn. They got to see something. They don't believe it. Mm-mm. They got to see it. So Lord, open up his spiritual eye. Let him see that spirit.
Mm.
And you did that, dear sister who didn't believe she had a spirit husband. You allow her to see that spirit in the bed with her. Let him see that spirit.
So where does these things come from? What are they?
They are demons. You know, when Lucifer, before he came Satan, was in heaven, and he was rebellion. He wanted what God had. And he deceived 1/3 of the angels. Now, in heaven, there are beings upon beings of angels, so 1/3 of beings are beings of angels.
That's a lot.
So the scriptures tell us that when he made that rebellion and the 1/3 of the angels went with him, Jesus kicked them all out.
Yes.
So when because he said, I saw Satan fall as lightning from the sky. They were coming down fast. And Jesus kicked them out.
Yeah.
So when Jesus kicked them out, their form changed. They no longer were beautiful angels anymore. They were evil, twisted, evil.
Ugly.
Hideous looking. Even Lucifer, he changed. It's hideous looking.
Yeah.
So now they down on earth. Now at the time that they were kicked out, there were no such thing as different states and countries you see now. The earth was void, null and void. And matter of fact, it was just pure water.
It was just water.
Yeah. Because the scripture said when the Lord spoke, he spoke to the firmament. And when the land went back in certain parts.
Yeah. Right.
A water form was there, but he pushed back the land in certain areas.
Right.
So keep in mind that when Jesus was forming earth, Satan and his demons were down here.
Yes, he was.
And then when the Lord created Adam, they were really angry then. Lucifer wanted what Adam had. And then when Eve came on, they really was angry. So he went to fight. So they are demons. Now remember now, when they was in heaven, and they had some type of power. When Jesus gave you a gift, he don't take it back. But when they became evil, that gift became twisted.
Yeah, okay.
It became twisted. So every disease that one can name on earth, that is actually a personality of a demon spirit.
Wow.
Lord told me that every disease, that is that demon spirit's personality. That's who that demon spirit is. So when that spirit enter a person, that's what the person becomes.
Oh.
Because of that spirit in them.
Oh, okay.
Because they're only aiming to kill, to steal, and to destroy.
Boy.
And you talk about billions among billions of demons because of the number of a multitude of angels in heaven. And
exactly. Nobody, no human being, no human being knows how many angels God created. He didn't never reveal that either. He don't know.
One third of the host of angels was deceived by Satan And now they are demons on earth.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
And we don't know them by name unless the Holy Ghost tells us their name.
Right.
So that's why the Holy Spirit must reveal to us who's the strong man. You don't have to know the name. Oh, just show me tell me who the strong man, Holy Ghost. And you bind the strong man and cast the strong man out. Then the other demons will go.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Well, this time so for mine, he's been here for a while.
Yeah, they got to go. Just like God said to my human helper.
Yeah, they've been living free. I've got no money for rent. They've been living for free around here.
You ain't got no money for rent. Just got destruction from
that
them.
Destruction.
Just destruction from them.
Yeah, because it comes against my finances. It comes against my marriage. It comes against people with people that don't want to. Everything.
Yeah, because everything. That's what makes them happy. Misery makes them happy.
Exactly.
Amen. But praise the living God, Antoinette. He's going to set you free.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I use the cross as for the devils, because this reminder that their legal right has been taken away due to this empty cross. You know, it's not a crucifix. You don't see no person on this cross. Jesus, not on this cross. That's why you get rid of crucifixes. As a matter of fact, the devil's not even afraid of no crucifix. He'll turn it upside down. The crucifix is saying, that you saying Jesus still on that cross. No, exactly. Jesus rose. He resurrected. He's on the right-hand side of our Heavenly Father, interceding for us today. He is alive. And this serves a reminder to demons that they don't have that legal right. But if they can continue to deceive a person by having lack of knowledge of God's word, they'll continue to stay in God's house, because our body is the house for the Holy Ghost, not for demons.
Amen.
Okay. So first, Antoinette, I'm going to pray for you.
Yes, ma'am.
As I pray for you, what I say next is directed at the strong man with the spirit husband. And all his friends, his little helpers, and confront them to come out of God's house. Now, I don't know how Jesus, who is the deliverer, I only decree in this physical realm the will of God to be done, and Jesus does it in heaven. So I don't know if Jesus is going to allow demons to make their exit known or not. That's up to the Lord.
Okay.
But if he do, you don't let it cause you to doubt.
Yes, ma'am.
It's only evidence, physical evidence, that they have left. And even if he don't allow them to make their exit known, they still will be leaving.
That's right.
So you receive by faith.
Amen. Let the Lord have his way.
Whether you see or hear or feel anything or not,
amen.
Your evidence that God set you free is only your faith in his word. Because it's not his will that you remain bound in your soul and in your body.
Right.
That's the reason why he died and said, it is finished. Based on his word alone, you are free.
Amen.
Again, he will allow us to experience something. And that's for his reason. And a lot of times it's for the unbeliever.
Yes.
A lot of times. But we are believers. We don't have to see. We don't have to fear. We just believe in God's word. Okay? Praise the living God. So I'm going to pray for you now. So Father, in Jesus' name, I just thank you for this opportunity, this day you've given me to mention your grace and mercy to your dear daughter, Antoinette. Truly, Father, it is her time to go forth and shine for your son's glory. Father, I thank you for keeping her, sealing her with your spirit into the day of redemption and keeping her, Father. Continue to give her wisdom, revelation, and even understanding as to who she is in your son's name and also who Jesus is in her. Thank you, Father. Thank you for raising her up to be a powerful woman of the Most High God. Father, I just thank you for what you're about to do in her life. There are souls who are in darkness, waiting on her deliverance, because their deliverance is tied to her deliverance, Father. And I thank you, Lord, that through her, your son, Jesus Christ, shall receive the glory. Thank you for cleaning your house this day, for it's not your desire to coexist with demons. You living in the spirit, in our spirit, while demon living in our soul, which is our mind, will, emotion, and our body. That is not your desire. You want the total man, not some, but the total. You want spirit, soul, and body. And Antoinette wants you to have her spirit, her soul, and her body. I thank you, Father, for you're the only one that can clean us up. And we believe and have faith in your word to do so. Father, I also decree and speak in the atmosphere, the door. Doors with the enemy have closed off to Antoinette due to her lack of knowledge in your word. Some of those doors was doors that you desired to be opened, but the enemy closed those doors because, again, of her lack of knowledge. Well, I decree in the atmosphere for every one of those doors that the enemy have closed, I decree in the atmosphere, open! 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 In Jesus' name. And also, Lord, doors that the enemy opened that was never your will to be opened, I decree in the atmosphere, close! 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 Close in Jesus' my name. And I seal those doors in and with the blood of Jesus, but they'll never be opened or reopened again. In Jesus' mighty name. Again, Father, I thank you for your presence here. You said you'd be with us when there's just two of us gathered together in your Son, Jesus Christ, of Nazareth's name. Father, I also am here to remind you of your word. You said, and I choose to believe your word, that whatsoever I bind, and Antoinette and I are in agreement in your word this day, right now, that whatsoever I bind and I loose in this physical realm, you, Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, by your Holy Spirit, will be binding and loosing in the heavens. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name. So on that note, spirit husband, come to attention. Come to attention. Now, I want you to gather all your loads. Snatch and grab every spirit that you allow to enter into God's house, into Antoinette's mind, her will, her emotion, and her body. Grass snakes, python, Jezebel, all those other little demons at your bed. I want you to wrap them around your waist. Bind them tightly, tightly around your waist. Get them, grab them. That's right, grab them all. Bind them tightly around your waist. Get everything you put in her body, every object that you put in and even on her body, take it out. Take it off and take it out. Take it out. Take your spiritual poison out of her body. Take those evil garments off her body. Take your rings. Take them. Take that crown. Take those garments of filthiness. Everything you put in and on her body and even in her body. Take them out. Take them out. Everything. In Jesus' name. Now, gather your loads. Pack them. Pack your things. And get out. Get out of her mind. Take all your filthy images out of her mind. Evil memories. Go deeply down to the conscious, subconscious level of her mind. Everything that belongs to you, and take them out. Get out. Get out of her mind. Get out. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you to loose. Loose his daughter and let her go. Let her go. And you turn loose her will. Turn loose her will. Get out of her will. Gather your things and get out. Take your chains and shackle your locks. Locks. Take them locks. Get them out. Unlock them locks. Unlock them. Unlock them. Take the lock. Give me the key. Give me the key. I cast those keys at the Father. He destroys them. In Jesus' name. Every padlock you use in a mind, every padlock you use in emotion, in a will, in a body, and on a body. Unlock it, unlock it, unlock it, unlock, unlock, unlock. Unlock in Jesus' name. And give me the key. You take them locks and give me the key. And again, I cast those keys at the Father. He destroyed those keys. Come out of her emotion. Get every spirit you invited into her emotion and get out. Get out. Get out. Get out of the Father's house. Get out of her emotions in Jesus' name. And you come out of her body. Loose her body. Loose her body. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you to loose. Loose in Jesus' name. Loose in Jesus. Get out. Out. All of you. Out. 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 You're not of the Godhead family. Get out. Get out. Holy Ghost, I call upon you in Jesus' name. Search and destroy darkness, still trying to cling and hold to Antoinette's mind. Burn every stubborn, lingering spirit that's been embedded into the conscious and subconsciousness of a mind, and you set them ablaze. Burn every image that is not of you. Set ablaze, Holy Ghost. Just ransacker mind. Ransacker mind, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, burn everything that's not in a mind. Burn, 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 spirit of wickedness, sleeplessness. Burn, burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn. Continue to consume her mind. Consume them all. Consume them all, Holy Ghost. Consume them all. Consume them all in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her mind in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, destroy those stubborn spirits that still trying to cling and hold to her will. Burn every illegal hand in her will. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost, and consume them all. Consume them all, Holy Ghost. Ransack her will by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, burn. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her will in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, destroy all the lingering spirit that's stubbornly trying to cling home to her emotions. Every spirit in her emotion that don't move like you, walk, talk, act, or react like you, Holy Ghost, set them ablaze. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Consume them all. Consume them all, Holy Ghost. Burn everything that's not in her emotions. Burn! Burn those lying spirits in her emotion. Burn all falseness in her emotion. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn! In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her emotion in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, burn those spirits of darkness that's still trying to live in her body. Burn those snakes in her eye. Burn every spirit that come up, look out through the window of her eye. Burn around her eye, the front, the back, and the side of her eye. Some ablaze, some ablaze, some ablaze, Holy Ghost. Let's ransack her eyes by your consuming fire. You close the door, Roger. Ransack her eyes. Burn. Burn. All that is not in you that comes up, look through her eyes. Burn. Burn. Burn by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost. Consume them all. Consume them all. Consume them all in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash her eyes. Clean her eyes, redeem her eyes, purify her eyes, rinse and baptize her eyes in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, destroy spirits of darkness even in her nose and her nostrils. Burn every living creature in her nose and her nostrils, and you set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack her nose and nostrils by your consuming fire. Burn, 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 burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash her nose and nostrils. Clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her nose and nostrils in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, destroy spirits of darkness that's living in her mouth. Burn in her mouth, under her tongue, on top of her, between her teeth. Burn, Holy Ghost, all that's not even her mouth. Grand shake her mouth by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, consume the mouth. Consume the mouth in her mouth. Burn, burn, burn impurities in her mouth. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her mouth in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, destroy those spirits of darkness, even in her ears and hearing. Set her ears and hearing ablaze by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, consume them all. Consume them all. Burn, burn, burn those lying, whispering spirits in her ears and hearing. Burn! Burn, Holy Ghost. Ran shake her ears and hearing by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, burn, 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 burn on the inside of her ears and hearing, even on the outsides of her ears. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn, burn every false sound that is not of you. Consume them all. Consume them all. Consume them all, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost fire, wash. Rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her ears and hearing in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn those spirits of darkness, even living up and down her throat. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn. Don't lie, spirits in her throat. Burn in her throat. Burn, 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 burn. All that is now you in her throat. Set them all ablaze. Set them all ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Ghost, all that is now you in her throat. Burn. Burn! Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her throat in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, go deep down her belly. Burn those lying spirits in her belly. Burn those snakes in her belly. Burn their eggs. Burn every dormant spirit in her belly. Burn spirits look like animals, insects, sea creatures. Take your human fashion, shape, and form. Set them all ablaze. Burn everything in her belly that is not of you, that don't move, even move that is not of you. Burn, 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 Holy Ghost, even in her stomach. Burn, Holy Ghost, snakes in her stomach, worms in her stomach. Burn, Holy Ghost, set her belly and stomach ablaze by your consuming fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, consume them all. Consume them all that is not of you. Burn, burn, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify her stomach and belly in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn spirits of dark in her uterus, in her womb, in her ovary, in her fallopian tube. Uproot and burn every plant my Heavenly Father have not planted in her body. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn. 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 Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, wash those areas. Rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, and purify and baptize those areas in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, destroy spirits of darkness living in her vagina. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every spirit in her vagina, Holy Ghost. Set her vagina ablaze by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, consume them all. Consume them all, Holy Ghost, even in her rectum. Burn those dark spirits living in her rectum. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn in Jesus' name. Consume them all. Holy Ghost fire, wash, rinse, clean, redeem, ransom, purify, and baptize her vagina. In her rectum, in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, burn on top of her head, on her forehead, on her face, her ears, back of her neck, her throat, up and down her arms, on her shoulder, up and down her back, up and down her stomach, her breast. Up and down her legs, on her feet, her hand, her fingers, her toes. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every body, piercing, tattoo coming in the physical and spiritual realm. Uproot and burn and destroy by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, burn every mark that was made on her body, physically and spiritually. Destroy those evil marks, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost fire, burn, burn. Burn spiritual wickedness on her body. Holy Ghost fire, wash her body. Clean her body. Redeem her body. Purify her body. Rest her body and baptize her body in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take the scissors of the Most High God. I cut and detach Antoinette from every covenant, contract, and agreement written in her name, her family name, that written on top of the earth, under the earth, in the world, and taken in the hell. I destroy those covenant, contracts, and agreements. In Jesus' name, I disconnect her from the evil spirit marriage. I disconnect her from evil spirit husband, spirit wife, those spirit children, the entire spirit family. I disconnect her from every relationship in the spirit realm by whom the Father did not connect her to. I disconnect because the blood of Jesus disconnects her and sets her totally free by his shed blood. Even in this natural realm, every relationship my Heavenly Father did not connect Antoinette to, I disconnect from those relationships because the blood of Jesus did not connect her.
Amen.
And sets her totally free by his shepherd. Antoinette, in the name of Jesus Christ, and never be free. I speak to the mind. Mind, be free. Will, be free. Emotions, be free. Dreams, be free. Visions, be free. Career, be free. Circumstances, be free. Body, be free. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. Now, Father, fill your daughter to overflow with your spirit. Fill her mind, her will, her emotions, her dreams, her vision, her career, her fans, and fear her body to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Now, Holy Ghost, sick him. Go in Antoinette's house and destroy every spirit that hovers in every corner, crack, and crevice of that house. Go in every room, every bedroom, and destroy darkness. The hovers around the bed, over the bed, foot of the bed, the front of the bed, under the bed, even between the top of the bed, between the sheets of the mattress, and destroy darkness. Don't leave no space untouched. Go in the wall, the ceiling, the floor. Destroy darkness.
Amen, Jesus.
Even the objects in that house that Dalton had cleaned themselves to destroy those evil objects. Objects that are known and or unknown to her. Destroy objects that have been planted on the floor, the ceiling, the wall. Locate and destroy every object, Holy Ghost. Consume them all. Consume them all, Holy Ghost. And destroy those objects. In Jesus. Go even outside the house. Destroy the hoovers around the house. Mm-hmm. Over the house, under the house, even underground under the house. And destroy door. Even at her workplace. Destroy the hoovers at her workplace, Holy Ghost. Destroy door. Don't leave no space untouched in her workplace. Even hidden objects in her workplace. Destroy those evil objects. Holy Ghost fire. Destroy every covenant, contract, and agreement written in her name, her family name, on top of the earth, under the earth, under the water, and take it into heaven. Destroy those covenant, contracts, and agreements. Even objects that was thrown on top of the earth, buried under the earth, take it into water, into heaven. In her name, her family name, destroy those evil objects. Consume them all, Holy Ghost. Consume those evil objects. Burn, Holy Ghost, even the water that was used to bathe her in. Destroy that water. Destroy, Holy Ghost. Consume the water by fire. Consume the water by fire, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, 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 burn in Jesus' name. Burn every handwriting that consists of her name, her family name.
Thank you, Jesus.
On top of the earth, under the earth, in the water, and take it into heaven. Destroy those evil handwriting. Destroy, 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 destroy. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for breaking all covenant contracts and agreements. Thank you, Lord, for setting this captive free. Now, Father, I ask you, that spiritualist that Antoinette went to, send forth your Holy Spirit to convict him of sin, righteousness, and judgment. let him see himself in hell burning. Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Even the young lady that referred her, convict her of sin, righteousness, and judgment, and let her see herself burning in hell. In Jesus' mighty name. But it's not your will that no man should perish. But they need for the scales to come off their eye to see who they truly is serving, the evil one.
Amen.
Take the scales off their eye to see, so they can see who they truly is serving. Let them see true, Father, in Jesus' name. And remember Antoinette's husband. Let him see that spirit that's claimed to be his wife. Let him see that spirit. Remove the scales from his eye to see truth.
Yes, God.
Convict him of sin, righteousness, and judgment. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Glory to his holy name. Antoinette, it's done. You're free. That means those demons are no longer living in your mind, your will, your emotion, nor your body.
Amen.
You are free. That covenant that you formed unknowingly with the devil when you was initiated deep into the kingdom of darkness through that bath, it's been disconnected. Even that bath water had been consumed by fire. Do you ever wonder what he did with that bath water?
No,
you never wonder about what he did. Didn't even ask, did you?
No.
Darkness had him to do something with that bath water, to keep that bath water. That was that covenant agreement. But it's been consumed with fire.
Hey, Jesus.
By fire. Fire has been consumed it. He's like, what happened? What happened?
Ooh. Mm-hmm. They kept it?
Yeah, they keep stuff like that. People are so foolish and naive. When some witch doctor get your things and bathe you, they be keeping that water and they offer it to their gods. It's their sacrifice. You get all kind of sickness and disease and
yes,
in your body.
But, yes.
The Holy Ghost to consume that water by fire.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Only the Holy Ghost can do that. Don't think they take and just pour it out and disregard it. No, no, no. You know, there are women where Satan targets certain men who's really supposed to be really big in the spirit of the Lord. Lord got a big plan for them. But Satan targets those men. They know the weakness of women. So he'll use a beautiful woman to deceive them and have sex. Do you not know that woman will take and get their semen and put it in a container and take it to a witch doctor?
Jesus.
Yeah, they do that.
For what?
To curse the person. And the person wonder why bad things can happen to them. They can't advance in the kingdom of God. They keep these beautiful women coming to them for sex in the dream. Just can't get ahead. Disappointment, disappointment, disappointment.
Right. That's right. That's what's been happening to you too.
That's why. They get your thing. They get your body fluids, the Lord said. Your body fluids.
Yes. Woods, yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
But I spoke in this natural realm, the Father did in spirit. The Holy Ghost destroyed it.
Yes, God.
And you know, this is no joke. This is real. I know I sound foolish. And it is foolish to an unbeliever, the person who is distant from the Lord. It does sound foolish, but it's true.
It is true.
So what was your experience in doing the fire prayers?
What was my experience?
Yeah.
I don't feel any different, not this minute, but I mean, I believe in the word of God, so I just believe that God is going to do what he's supposed to do for me, and that's it.
No, you reword that.
Okay.
I have did it, not
God has done it. He has done it. I'm standing on the word of God. Amen.
Now, Lord, just tell me why he didn't allow you to feel anything. Because you go by your feeling. When you went to that witch doctor, the spiritual, you saw the things he was doing. You saw it with your eye. So you believe. You believe.
Yeah.
See, we serve a God where only faith pleases him.
Amen.
So he wants you to receive by faith, not by your faith.
Feeling.
He'll allow you to see and feel, and you believe. Right. I'm not going to let you feel and see a thing, Antoinette. You have to believe me by faith. You believe that witch doctor, that person, because of the acts that he did.
That's right. That's true.
So I'm not going to let you feel the thing.
Amen.
But he did. I saw it. I felt what he did. Now, he didn't let you see or feel, but he let me feel and see. He did it. He wants you to walk by faith in his word, not by your feeling. Well, I know the Lord said it because I felt it. Wrong. That's not faith in a beckoning to you.
I know.
So Jesus offered faith. He did it in the spirit realm. It's done.
It's done. Amen. It's just a manifestation of it. It's gonna come. It's already here.
Ain't no such thing. It's done. What you just said, there's no such thing. It's done.
All right.
You're gonna walk it out by faith.
It's done.
See,
it's done.
Faith is now, not later on. It's now. Remember, Jesus often finished our faith. He's often finished your faith.
That's right.
You know, you're a person, you like to feel something. I like to feel this thing.
Yes.
Not so, Antoinette. He has to believe that I did it.
Yes,
when
ma'am.
When you're told to believe, then when what you're looking for in the natural to see or feel,
you're
like, I knew it all along.
Exactly. Yeah, it's just like that centurion. When that centurion came to him and said that his servant was sick, and when God said he'll come to his house and heal him, and he said, I'm a man under authority. I don't need
to speak that word.
Speak the word.
Yeah, because I have servant. He said, I have servant. I just tell them to do this, and I speak that word. They do it. So I know you are a higher power and authority than I am. Just speak that word.
Speak that word.
Right. Just speak it to me. And Jesus spoke that word. And sure enough, he received. His servant was healed.
Amen.
Say it, Jesus. Amen. I just didn't really need to hear you. Just say it. I believe it. I'm still hurting. I'm not going by this feeling that I'm hurting. I'm believing your word.
I believe in your word.
Hold on to your word. You know,
amen.
Jesus had to teach me this, Antoinette.
Yeah.
You know, when I was a baby Christian, I asked the Lord to do something. He jumped and did. The time you got to grow. So as a baby Christian, not allow that to help our faith. We need that as babies Christian.
Yes, we do.
Stay that way. Your faith got to grow. You got to grow.
Yes, ma'am.
And then I noticed after a while, I started asking the Lord something, and answer didn't come as quick. And I said, what? Mm-hmm. I said, just ask, and it happened. But now, and best when I started talking to the Lord, he would talk back.
Hey!
I would say something to him, and I'd wait for him to say something. He would say, and I'm like, what? And I knew that Jesus was not there.
Yes.
Like before. And I was what is going on? Got quiet on. And I'm like, hold up now, what is going on? Holy Spirit said, I would never leave you, I never forsake you. You
got to believe. Hey, hallelujah.
I was like, okay. So I said, Jesus, you ain't saying nothing to me. I know you're here. You know why I know you're here? Because you said you would never leave me, you never forsake me.
So that's right.
Nothing, it don't matter because I know you're here. So I'm going to keep talking to you. I did not feel him. I did not sense him entering in.
No.
I received him by his word. No. But he said he would never leave me. He'll never forsake me.
That's right.
And I would just talk to him. He would never say nothing, and I didn't feel he was there, but I kept on. I said, Jesus, I still believe your word that you are right here because you said you never leave me, you never say nothing. And I kept on.
Right.
Antoinette, I kept on. I don't know how long it was, but not know? Jesus said something. I said, I knew you was here. And the Lord told me,
well, you know.
And Lord told me why he did it. He did tarry. He said, your faith got to grow in me.
That's right. That's right.
You have to believe my word.
I have to believe because this experience has taught me to believe in prayer. I did not know that prayer was that powerful. I did not know. I got saved, but I did not know that praying to the Lord is able to do the things that he says it will do. And so God has allowed me to see with these two eyes that he's a merciful God. And like you said, he never leaves us nor forsake us. So even though I'm going through the storm right here, right now, or whatever, God still allowed me to know that my word goeth forth and it goes swiftly.
And you praise him and you worship him and praise and worship him in the devil's faith, in spite of. Praise him in advance. I mean, I've been through it.
I pray.
If you had many years ago, if you had looked at me, you would have thought I was a child of the devil. Why? Because things was not going according.
Yes.
It wasn't going right. It was like God had just forsaken me, turned his back on me. It was terrible. But the Lord said, Terry, praise me in advance. I mean, we were even judged as not being a child of God because of things we were going through.
Yes.
Terry, I'm working on your faith. Will you trust me? Trust my word. He said,
now
praise
me in advance. Hallelujah.
I would be praising like a lunatic woman. I had a sister. Yes. I was praising the Lord one time. I had a sister come in my ear and say, sister, it don't take all of that. Let me tell you right now, it's a dangerous thing to mess with a true worshiper. Because that true worshiper is worshiping the
Father.
Just like David's wife, first wife, mocked him.
Yes.
When she saw him worshiping the Lord, she got cursed.
Yes, she did.
David no longer went into her.
Yes.
You never had any trouble. You would get cursed when you mess with a true worshiper. And this sister, as I was worshiping the Lord, sacrificing that worship because I was hurt because my situation, but I was praising him in advance, Antoinette. This sister came in here and said, sister, it don't take all of that. You know what happened to that sister a few days later?
No.
That very same sister, husband, took her two children in him and left her. And she kept crying that her husband and children was gone. And Lord said, don't mess with a true worship. She cursed herself when she messed with a true worship because that worship was not for her, it was for Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise him in advance. I praise him in advance. I kept on. A lot of them were praising God because things was going well. But I was praising God in spite of, so that made me more than a conqueror.
That's right.
And God, eventually, my blessing was manifested upon this
earth. Hey, Jesus.
Said,
hallelujah.
I will not allow you to be homeless. In the natural intellect, it looked like my family and I was homeless. Lord said, I will not allow you to be homeless.
Yes.
And I kept on, I received that word. But in the natural, it looked like we were homeless.
Yes.
I looked at God's word.
Yes.
My faith was in his word, not in my circumstances looking like I was hungry. It was in his word.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
I kept pressing, praising God. And that's the reason why you see this anointed sister this day.
I know. I know.
It's going to cost you something. It's going to cost you something, dear heart.
Yes, it is. You know what? I've been asking God, what is my purpose? What is it you want me to do? He hasn't revealed it to me yet, but I know he has a purpose
Keep
for me.
On.
I know. I know he will because this is not just from the devil. I know the Lord would allow the devil to do these things because he wants you to run to him. I know that. I know because Lot is a perfect example of that because Lot didn't do nothing to deserve, but God allowed that to happen to him.
Show the devil that.
He was blessed for it because the devil already touched it. That's what I'm saying. He held on in there. So think about me going through this since 2017.
if it wasn't for God,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I couldn't hear. I would not be sitting here across from you talking to you like this.
Mm-mm.
And I just point you because I'm searching. I said, God, I said, I know you have appointed and anointed people on this earth. I
hey,
know
man,
you
man, man, man. Yes,
I
yes,
know
man.
You got
yes,
your mantle on this earth.
Yes,
I know Elijah can call down fire from heaven. I know you got somebody still
yes,
walking around here with the Holy Ghost to say,
hey,
my child, Lord.
Amen.
I said, devil, you cannot have me. I do not belong
amen.
To you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
That's what I told the devil. I said, you cannot have me. I said, you know the day. I said, because you know God want me. That's why you here. But you got to go. You are got to go.
Got to go. Got to go. Got to go.
Got to go. In Jesus' name. In Jesus'
Woo!
Name. So that's what I had to be doing up in here. I had to call on the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
You hear me? In
Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
Yes,
so that's
Lord.
Why I'm sitting right here talking to you right now. I'm telling you, I lost 40 pounds. Within 2 months, all my clothes was falling off me. My bra, what I put on, my bra would fall off me. My titties fell off. I said, Jesus, what is this? But God still covered me under the blood. The blood that was shed.
Grace and mercy kept you.
That blood. That blood got life in it. You see me? That blood that God shed, it got life. And when God says, when it's not your time, the devil cannot take you out. When it's not your time, who has to still be here? So God says,
undone. Your work is undone.
In the name of Jesus.
Work to do for the Lord.
I know the goodness of God. I'm telling you. And that's why, you know what? Yesterday I was talking to my husband. Like I tell you, we've been doing a tug of war. And yesterday God rested, just putting him in my spirit to talk to him. And I told my husband, I said, let me tell you something. I said, there's blessings and there's cursings in our mouth.
That's right.
And sometimes we as people, even though we say we're serving God, we curse ourselves by doing the wrong things.
That's right.
And the enemy entertains you when you're doing all this wrong stuff.
Yeah.
Because you are sick. And I said, there's a lot of people who would love to have somebody to come to touch and agree with them. You're a wife who is clinging to God. Why can't you call on me and say, baby, you know what? I can't pray right now, but pray for me. Read a scripture for me. Read this out of the Bible for me. You'll be sitting in here doing stuff that you don't have no business doing. But I tell him, I said, let me tell you something. At the end of the day, you're going to see the devil laughing at you when you're standing beside him, when you lose your salvation. And when you see, when God show you your life and show you all the opportunities that you missed. Because the Bible says, there's no repentance in the grave. So don't wait for judgment day to plead your
That's
cause
right.
to God. You
That's
cannot
right.
plead to God at that time. That's why it's called judgment day.
That's right.
And that's what I told him. I said, God can raise Lazarus from the dead. There is no sickness in your body that God cannot heal. You can wake
That's
up
right.
tomorrow morning completely healed.
That's right.
If you be honest with God. And that's what I told him. But I said, let me tell you something. You are not keeping me back from my salvation. I told
Amen.
Him that.
Amen. Amen.
You understand me? I said, choose today whom you will serve.
That's
choose. Because
right.
God says many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Mm-hmm.
But he delivers from them all. So I'm going to my, and I will go through it. Because God is allowing me to go through it.
That's right.
Because the storm don't last always. It really don't. It may look sometimes, but it don't. And that's what I told him. Today. I said, I'm just telling you what God put on my heart for you. I said, seek God while he may be found. Do it. Do it. Don't do it for me. Do it for yourself. Let us have holy peace in this house. Holy peace. Let the peace of God, the spirit of the living God be in this house. Stop bringing the devil and God in here. God don't work that way. You got to keep somebody out. So I leave my TV on. Every night I leave my TV on, YouTube money, nothing. Praise and worship and some prayers. The
That's
devil's
right.
not coming for something. No, man. I'm eating.
That's
I know.
Right.
That's what I do. Every night I leave my TV on. Every
That's
night
right.
it's on
That's
a
right.
prayer or some
That's
praise
right.
and worship. And when I cannot
That's
sleep, I get up, I put my headphones in, and I put some
right.
prayers and something in my ear, and I go to sleep, and I say, God, let me have sweet sleep, Lord. And I've been sleeping because, like I told you, I couldn't sleep. There was a time I could not sleep.
Mm-hmm.
You understand woman, and let me tell you, and then we can get off this phone. I remember the other day, because, you know, I'm a dreamer. I dream about mm-hmm. I dream about judgment. I dream about seeing God. I see God.
Mm-hmm.
And I dreamt, and I wasn't dreaming. And God allowed me to dream when I saw, like, you know, like they say a portal would open up in heaven, where you see mm-hmm. like something just open. You know, you watch the movie, you see something open up.
Mm-hmm.
And a portal in heaven was open. And God was waiting for me to look. But just out of the corner, you know, something catch the corner of your eye.
Mm-hmm.
I saw something catch the corner of my eye. And when I turned around, the portal was just about to close. And when God saw that turn around, he opened it up, and I saw God sitting on his throne, sitting on it. He had his crown on his head. It was a stone that was on the crown that was catching my eye. A blue, I can't even describe the blue. Mm-hmm. It was a beautiful blue stone that was sitting on the crown of his, in the crown, he was sitting on a big old throne, all white.
Mm-hmm.
And there was nothing but angels, and God was just pointing, and angels were just moving. You can tell he was giving them the assignment, and God pointed. He pointed down at me, and the angel was coming to me, and I just woke up. I said, God, amen, in the name of Jesus, I know that you remember me. So from then on, I stopped worrying. I said, devil, you'll be all right. God gonna deliver me. Amen.
You did. Thank you, Jesus.
Word about you, say no. God is real. He's working on my behalf.
Thank you. Amen, Antoinette. Antoinette, now you share, when I post this on my YouTube, you share with family and friends.
Yes, ma'am, I will.
Don't let the enemy keep you ashamed.
I will.
Because whenever you're ashamed, that sin,
no,
that opens door for the enemy to come in. See, we overcome the enemy by the blood of Lamb, plus the word of our testimony.
Amen.
So you share.
Okay. Amen. Amen.
You know, amen. Keep me posted. You got my email. Keep me posted.
Yes, ma'am. I will.
Okay.
And I ask the Lord to bless and keep you also, because you're doing a good work. Because there's a lot of people out here who are being held captive by the devil, and they don't know where to get no help. So I will definitely pass your name on to whoever comes my way. I sure will. God bless you. And I thank you.
Now you let them know that there's two sessions. There's a group deliverance session. I meet people in a group. And that group deliverance session do not require a suggested donation. But if you want my one-on-one time, then that's
suggested
donation.
Okay. Okay. But you don't have like a prayer line. You only have corporate prayer. That's what
Tuesday morning at 8 o'clock is corporate prayer. I don't have
corporate prayer. Okay. Deliverance TV.
I don't have the time to do a prayer line.
Okay, but the Deliverance TV is where you do the group session.
No, if they want to do the group session, then you refer them to the website radio.holyghostfire.us, and it gives them instructions. They have to download the Zoom app. Like download the Zoom app on their Android or iPhone or the computer. Then they send me an email. I love to receive emails from a person saying, Evangeline, I already downloaded the app. So that shows me you did your homework. So what I do, I just send you the date and the time of that next group session.
Okay, and this number that you gave me works for your session?
No.
Is it a different number?
It would be a different meeting ID. So listen carefully.
Yes, ma'am.
What they need to do is download the Zoom meeting app.
Zoom meeting app, yes, ma'am.
Just like you did. You went to the radio. You went to the radio.holyghostfire.us. It have a link to the Android, the iPhone.
Yes, ma'am.
Market for the Zoom app and a link to download it on your computer.
Yes,
once
ma'am.
You download it, then you contact me and say, Vanish King, I have downloaded the app.
Okay.
So I have to say, right there, I know that you read it. So what I'm going to do, I will send you the meeting ID, the date and time for that next group session.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay.
I know you told me about it in an email yesterday. Say it was like March 10th at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock, something like that.
The next group session is, hold on 1 second. I think we'll be on a safe side. Is this coming up Sunday at 3 p.m.?
Oh, okay. And that's what I told you.
Sunday, March the 10th 2019 right. at 3 p.m. Right. So again, they have to install the Zoom app.
Right.
Then they send me an email and say, Vegetarian, I have installed the app.
Right.
I like receiving them, those emails, yeah. because that person is ready. And when I get that, then I will reply to give them the meeting ID.
Okay.
Date and time for that group session.
Now,
They want a one-on-one session like you, then
yeah.
they have to send that minimum $50 donation.
Got you. Yes, ma'am.
PayPal.me.
And I got one. What do you use on your hair? What do you use on your hair? Because your hair is so thick and beautiful. What do you use?
You say, this is thick. Well, there's nobody but God. I said, Lord, let me see you. I had a bit more comb my hair in a couple of days. He did. He did. The Lord doing.
It's beautiful.
Thank you. I'm about ready to get my perm. That's a testimony about my hair. It's a testimony about this hair.
Mm-hmm. Not mine. Permanently, I can't. The natural is okay, but let me ask you something. Is anything wrong with wearing makeup? Because I've been hearing a lot of people talk about makeup. Is anything wrong with wearing makeup?
I'll tell you what the Holy Ghost told me when this girl asked me. This girl said, "Vesky, I know you say it's wrong with makeup." I said, "I never said it was wrong to wear makeup." No, the Holy Ghost said, "No, it's just wrong to make yourself up." Now the Holy Ghost told me that I didn't make this up. So that's right. It's not wrong to wear makeup. You just don't make yourself up. You know what that means?
No.
When you make yourself up, you change your appearance. You got so much makeup on, you don't even look like yourself.
Oh, Lord. You look like a drag queen.
And like a clown. Someone look like a clown. Yeah. So you make yourself up. But wearing light makeup, lipstick.
Yeah.
That's fine. Don't wear nothing false. We shouldn't be wearing false hair, false eyelashes, false nails. False is known to Satan. Jesus is true God. There's nothing false about Jesus. Jesus cursed falseness.
Oh, so the false, and the extensions and the weave and all that stuff, he's not into.
All that false stuff. That belongs to the kingdom of darkness.
Where their property
is. That's why a lot of women have these migraine headaches. Like something like pounding their head. Because demons are literally pounding their head. That's why their hair is falling out.
Yeah.
Now they feel like they got to wear a wig now to cover up those bald spots.
Yeah.
See how the devil wants to keep them confined to wearing falseness.
Yeah. Okay, I got you. Now I understand, because a lot of people, like some Africans, have been telling you not to wear, don't wear no makeup. And you know,
sometimes people go overboard.
Yes. Yes.
As long as you're not changing your appearance. Because a lot of these women that you see, you really never seen the woman. You never really seen them before. You just see them. When I look at women, especially Christian women, they all look alike. Because when they put on that thick makeup, it makes them all look alike.
Yeah. They got too much. They got like 15 pounds of makeup on their face. No, Lord.
Right. That's why, like in Africa, that's why it's been reported that men have divorced their wives on their honeymoon. Like they took them to the and the woman got to their makeup. And the man said, I want divorce because she's fraud. Because it's not the woman that I married.
She ugly without the makeup.
Terrible compared to the makeup. So she really deceived the man. That was deception.
Yes, she deceived. So if I'm coming down to North Carolina, can I let you know? Because I would really love to meet you in person.
Yeah, I have Holy Ghost Fire Deliverance meetings. Matter of fact, I just started back one this month. I think it's the 16th.
No, it's not right now. Maybe a couple of months down the road. But
check the website, radio.holyghostfire.us, and you see Holy Ghost Fire Deliverance meeting. I always put the date and time there.
Come on out.
I never know who the Holy Ghost is going to send, but I know the Holy Ghost is going to send somebody, but I never know who.
Because
sometimes we do need Holy Ghost hands laid upon us. We do need that sometimes.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Yes, ma'am. All right. God bless you, and thank you.
So now you make sure you get rid of your mother, Bishop Aaron. Okay. And also ask the Holy Spirit if there's anything else in your house that hinders your father's presence.
Yes, ma'am.
Reveal it to you so you can get rid of it. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. I will.
All right.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Internet. You too. Stay blessed. All right.
All right. All right.